Somebody standing there had to volunteer and say, I'll take you down to the pool.
Hallelujah.
Wonder why the Bible don't tell us all that. Because God's ways are not ours.
Godly.
But somehow, he got to the pool.
Yes, he did.
Because the Bible said he came seeing. And there was lots of controversy about it. He come on into town talking about this man whose ways was not his ways.
Come on.
And they asked him, said, who was this done this? And he told them. And they asked him again. He said, listen, I done told you once. Now I'm going to tell you again. I don't know. I just know I was blind, but now I see.
Amen.
And his old stick and the muds got together. They wasn't even happy that the man could see, Brother Tony. Have you ever seen God just do marvelous things? It's happened in this church. God's healed cancer.
Yes, he is.
People's got up and talked about it for months, and then went and acted like the devil. And you're like, oh. They wasn't even concerned that the poor man had been blind all his life, and all of a sudden he could see him. They wasn't even excited about that. They was just wanting to know who in the world had sinned. Why was this man born blind? Was his mom and daddy sinned or he sinned? Did it matter who sinned? The thing was, the mud was washed out. The man's sin, the sins was washed away. It didn't matter why the man had been blind. Don't you get sick of people being like that? God will just do miracle after miracle after miracle. And then somebody will say, but why did they put that songbook on the end of the bench? You're like, are you for real?
Well,
do you understand what I'm saying? Something that's totally irrelevant. Don't make a lick of sense. You should be praising God for what God has done. And somebody's like, well, why did it? God done miracles. He done signs, Brother Robert. He done wonders because his ways are far above ours. His power is so beyond us. And if we were about this, I'm on frivolous stuff. Wow. And we've had red seas before us, as Brother Roger was talking about. But some people, just the slightest little thing, Brother Bo, they're like, ah!
Woo!
When God has done the children of Israel, they drank water out of a rock.
Yes.
He bring little cookies down out of the sky. He let their shoes grow with their feet. And the first little thing that come up, it was like, now Moses, why you got us out here to die? We'd rather be back in guarding onions and making bread. God done brought them through all of that stuff, Brother Tony, but they forgive us. His thoughts are not ours. Many things in the Bible is examples of how God's thoughts and ways are so far above our thinking. That's why we need him in our soul. Do you know you start to think like him?
Yes.
When you get him in you, when you feel with the Holy Ghost, the Bible said you receive power.
Power.
That's to think more like the Lord. To take on more of his mind. To take on more of his thoughts. Hallelujah. I keep saying this. He said, let this mind.
Let this.
He didn't say that Brother Sloan was going to put this mind in you. Didn't even say the Lord was going to come down and zap it. Say, now you got my mind. He said, let. How do you let the Lord?
You read his word.
Amen.
You get on your knees. If you're like me and you can't get on your knees, you find somewhere to pray. Hallelujah. You let this mind. You get it from getting in that word of God. From drawing close to it, Brother Tony. Amen. Of thinking about him. Keep your mind on him. He said, I will keep him in perfect peace. His mind is stayed.
Amen.
Wow. How many in here would love to have perfect peace?
Amen.
That's a bunch of peace. You hear me? There's only been a few times in my life that I had complete perfect peace. Something was always nagging.
Yes.
But you know what? When I come in the house, God's telling Sister Tina the other day, this has been the three hardest years of my life pastoring this church. Been the three hardest years of my life. And sometimes I just want to scream and run out the door. And all of y'all have felt that way. I guarantee you, every one of you in here has felt that way. If you've been coming here very long. Amen. Because the devil don't like us around here. But you know what? The only place I told her, I said, but you know what? When I get into services,
yes,
all of that leaves me. I have a perfect peace. Brother Roger, when I'm here, my legs ain't hurting this morning.
Well,
when I got out of my car at 1 o'clock this morning, after being gone on a three-day trip, loading equipment and unloading equipment, thank God for young men and young people and people who help you. But I still overdone myself. My ankles were swollen. My back was hurting. I was tired. Slept in a bed. It was a, what's the name of that motel? Best Western Plus. It was a good bed, but it wasn't my Tempur-Pedic, Brother Tony. And I was sore all over. When I got out of my vehicle, I was taking little bitty steps like the little precious people in the nursing home. Just like that. Dave done got in the house. He's 75. But he gets in the head of me. He done got in the house. And I'm like, Jesus. Oh, God. Help me, Lord. Just help me make it through tomorrow. And the devil said, you ain't gonna make it. Ain't no way you can do all this. Make it tomorrow. But you know what? When I woke up this morning, hallelujah. The Lord said, my strength I give to you.
Woo! Yes, hallelujah.
Oh, I ain't got no pain in my body. I tell my young people, I wish to goodness that y'all would let the Holy Ghost get a hold of you. You got good, strong bodies. Amen. Sister Sheena, I shout all I can. Amen. But I just can't move like I used to. I weigh 315 pounds. I'm 60 years old. Hallelujah. Had every bone in my body broke near me. I'm going to tell you, I used to just shout for the runners and drop of a hat. I'd just think about Jesus just a little bit. I'd be like, I'd get up in the middle of the floor in my living room. Didn't have to be no music. I'd just get up in the middle. One time I went out my back door. I've been talked about. Some said I've been lied on, cheated, talked about, Mr. Somebody said, oh, it's just a show. She just loud and likes to show out. If you do anything for God, folks are going to talk about you.
Yeah.
If you don't do nothing for
That's
God,
right.
They're going to talk about you.
Yeah.
You know what I've done, Sister Gina? I felt my back door open, and I walked down my steps. And Brother Roger, there wasn't no music playing.
Come on.
There wasn't nobody but me around. I walked down them steps. It had been troubling me. I walked down them steps. And I said, Jesus, this is just me and you.
Mm-hmm.
And I thank you for this little place you give us. Mm-hmm. Thank you for that tree over there. Thank you for my house. Thank you for my bed. And I looked down and I said, devil, I'm going to tell you something.
Yeah.
Ain't nobody but me and you and Jesus out here today. And if anybody hears about this, it's because
Glory.
You run and tell them. Can't nobody see me. But I'm fixing to tear this ground up in Jesus' name. You hear me? There ain't no music playing. Ain't nobody looking at me. But I'm fixing to shout like you ain't never seen this old factory show. Hallelujah. Listen, I didn't feel no great Shekinah glory, Sister Jerry. Do you know it's not easy just to go out your back door and decide you're going to dance before the Lord. It's easy in here with this music playing and all the strength we get from each other and all the encouragement. I was a few years younger. I'm going to tell you what. But Jason, I picked one foot up. I still a fat girl, but it's a lot younger. I picked one foot up. I picked up the other foot. Drip the yard always. If I get a little of this courage, brother Bo, I go to my kitchen door and I start looking at mom.
Perfect peace.
on your head. God, I just don't think I can take no more. Hallelujah. But I'm going to tell you, baby girl, you ain't here by accident this morning.
Oh,
some joy to you. Some things that the kangaroo has told.
Jordan's mama
Sister Crystal has to have surgery tomorrow. She should be here herself today. In the name of Jesus, these babies pray, amen, for their parents. They're the ones that brought them here. Now they're not here. Brother Roger, amen. But we're going to believe God one more time for Sister Crystal. Whatever this is, we know God can bring her through it. Let's pray that as he does this, she will begin to have a desire to be drawn back to the house of God. Because God's done so much in this little family. Jesus, you see, Sister Crystal. Lord, I don't know what her problem is or what the surgery is. But Jesus, you made her body. You can heal it, Lord. You can heal her mind. God, this old depression and aggravation that she feels. And God, give her a visitation, Lord. God, as this young man's tears drop on my hands, God, for his mother, Lord, you see our tears and you bomb them, God. And I ask you, Lord, to touch her. Touch this little family, make it whole, God. In Jesus' name, touch Crystal. Hallelujah. Touch his brothers and his little sister. In Jesus' name, hallelujah. Make your family whole, God. I praise you. I praise you. I praise you. Oh, hallelujah. Mama, don't you know he's a good God? Yes, he is. Good God, brother. Good God. I love it when big old boys cry out to Jesus. Hallelujah. Amen.
Change in her.
beautiful day.
Sister Sarah.
Hallelujah.
1 second before you go. I'm sorry. Go ahead, Ben.
All right, Jacob.
Babies, when they want prayer, we pray for them. Amen.
Jesus, you see this friend, Lord Jacob, is always concerned, Lord, about other people. And I ask you to touch her. God, you know all about it. Touch Katie, Lord. God, you're able to do this. Thank you for his compassion for others. Lord, and while you're touching this young lady, you touch Jacob, God, put a hedge around him, Lord. We thank you for how he's growing in you.